Okay. Good luck.
各位观众早上好。好。今天参加女子组决赛的运动员是。Today
Ready?
The following players attending the women's final.
Go.
来自中国的陈思敏，Chen from China， 请大家鼓掌。
Lock on, cut the first break.
We are here for the commentary. We've just got a couple of things to take care of first.
1 second.
Extension.
Color. Staying on the rock, one very low. Two, Chen's mean to bet. Second. You got tension. second. Expansion.
Okay. Seemed like she hit that ball a little bit soft. Kelly doesn't seem to be playing like she's playing on an eight ball table, on a Chinese billiard table. She looks like she's trying to play like she's playing on a standard 9 foot table, which is usually not a recipe for success. I can't tell you what's going on now because someone's blocking my way. Oh, okay. That didn't help her out at all. Now she's got 5 balls to choose from, and none of them look good. Well, she's got the 15. Sorry, she has 6 balls to choose from. She's got the 15 down here on the short rail, but she doesn't want to shoot that. That's a low percentage shot on this table. Got Kelly in a spot where it's going to be tough to play safe. She might be able to come off the side of the 3 and leave her on the left-hand side of the short rail, just daring her to take on something. Kelly went for it again. Every time she does that, she leaves a table that Chen should punish her on. Thank you. She doesn't want to be straight in. I don't like this angle on this 10 ball, but oops, she made it. That should be all the work she needs to do to get out here. This for a 2-0 lead. I really think, even though we're really early in the match, I think Kelly needs to change her approach. I mean, it's obviously got her this far, but I just can't imagine you can play this game as if you're playing on a standard 9-foot table and expect to beat a player who plays it. Imagine what she could be looking for in the rack. I'm guessing she can see the five. It looks like the 8-ball clears into this bottom left pocket. If so, we'll see our first table run. She hit that ball great. Three-zero Chen, and she is on break. I believe the men's finals start at 1 with the first session. They'll play 20 racks, and then they'll come back at 7. The women's final? She made a ball, but right off the bat, you can see the 8-ball is going to have to be moved off that rail. I think she's going to have to make the 4 and bump the 6. Okay, she moved the 6 out to where it's makeable. She can go 2-6. She's still going to have to move this 8 off the rail. I wonder if she's looking at 1-3 and then use the 6 to get on the long rail and just try the long 8-ball. Well, she's left herself pretty much straight in on the three. I guess this is where she wants to be. Decided not to break it off the rail and just bank it in. How's that for a heat check? Either that or just no respect for Kelly's game. Okay, Kelly's got the opportunity to make her pay for it. I don't think that bump's gonna hurt her at all. She's gotta like having three of these four balls in the side pocket. I think she would have liked to have come back a little further on this ball. Again, she came too far. Came too far by quite a bit. With this cloth, she can make the 10 and hold the cue ball not to bump into the 8. But she's going to have to come with a good shot here. She hit it good. She's still not, you know, this is not a hanger. That gets her on the board. 3-1, Chen. Pick. Kelly to break, trailing 3-1. And another dry break. I see the conversation in the chat room about bringing these tables over to America. We had a media sit down with the representative from Star Billiards the other day, and they said that it is a goal of theirs to bring this game to the States. It's just not something they're, you know, they don't have plans to do it immediately. I actually think she can play the 11, rail first, make it off the 7 down there. Surely, I wonder how many games they're considering the first session. My understanding is the men's first session is 20 racks. I wonder how many they're figuring for the ladies. Roughly 16, 17 games, probably. Thank you, JP. Did we ever? I think that ball would have gone. I just think she caught the rail too early. She needed to come deeper into the rail. Kelly with another golden opportunity here. It almost seems like the first player that tries to run out the rack sells out the rack, except for that one that Chen ran. No, Shirley, I did not give JP a kiss for you. I'll give him an orange. Will that be good enough? Thank you. Bump didn't help her out. Left her with a three ball a little more difficult than she wanted. I don't think she wanted the three next anyway. Okay, I don't think this was the way she drew the run up when she first looked at the table, but one ball to get on the eight and get back within one. Chen does not look amused. Boy, I don't know if that eight ball goes through there. She came up way shy of where she needed to be. Oh, that... She may be able to try it off the 11. I think she's trying it off the 11. Just like that. Chen with the ball on the break. A cluster of three balls, three stripes down here in the bottom left, but it looks like they're in a position where she can open them up fairly easily. I don't see any easy way for her to get this 12 ball off the rail. She's just going to have to live with that shot. Again, like Torsten was saying the other night when he was commentating the match, and Vincent, leaving these three trouble balls for the end is not usually the strategy you want to take. Now she's got problems. Again, Chen went for the run out, and now she's in a position to possibly sell this rack out. And with these three balls down here, of course, she's got Kelly's six ball tied up. And Kelly's got more problems than that. She's got the five ball to deal with. Now she's got the three ball to deal with. That was, not only did she open up Kelly's three, but then she also put her 10 on the rail, which is where she didn't want it to be. It sure looked like she had missed that ball from here. The four ball looks like her best opportunity to open up this six ball, but I personally don't like it. No, I don't think that worked out nearly the way she wanted it to. Nine-foot table, she'd be out in a heartbeat here, but... Chen's going to try to slide this 10 down the rail. She tried this shot earlier and missed it pretty bad. No, she's just trying to take over the pocket. I can't tell if she left that 6 makeable or not. TP.
side.
Kelly Fisher back to 3-3. And five of the six racks, we've seen one of the players go for the run out, fail it, and end up losing the rack. Looks like Kelly's taking a break after six racks. I thought the break was after eight. We're back, and Kelly's made a ball on the break and doesn't have anything to shoot at. get ready for a tactical battle here. It's a great shot to get things started there for Chen. I don't see it it looping on this end. I see it delayed quite a bit, but delayed by 3 or 4 shots here, but then again we're sending the signal back to the States and then we're receiving it back here again. That's the second bank like that she's missed. I'm trying to find out how many racks the first session is for the ladies. Looks like Darren's making a comeback. He now trails Lebo 5-4. We fixed it for you, Kathy. I don't think that worked out the way she had in mind. Okay, well, she blocked the 14 for Chen. She still got the 10. Thank you, Shirley. Boy, if she made that ball and left herself that window, she deserves to win this game. Very nicely done. This 8 ball to put Chen back on top, 4-3. Okay, Chen makes a stripe on the break. Chen certainly hasn't had a problem making a ball on the break. Looks like the 10 ball goes by the 6. Nice shot there to make her ball and put Kelly's ball in a tough spot. She's going to go for the out. Looks like she came out far enough for the 14 next. That ball, to borrow a phrase from an old matchroom commentator, that ball wiped its feet on the way in.
Thank you.
this perspective. Side. Christmas thing.
Boy, Kelly can't buy a ball on the break here. Okay, she's got, every ball has a pocket. Not sure she wants to shoot the seven down in the corner. She could make the four now. Open up the seven, have the two next. Was a surprising miss. Kelly's still going to get this 15 off the rail, and the 12-9 are not the easiest balls in the world.
Thank you.
shoot, we didn't update the match last night.
Yeah, I'm not going to take credit for that one, Kathy. I'd sure like to. Sorry about disappearing on everybody, dealing with little stuff here. We've seen this strategy applied a couple times in matches here on the TV table. Just give up ball in hand and put a ball on the rail. I think where she put it, Chen can make the four and then bring the six off the rail, which... I'm surprised she's going this way. That ball didn't look like it was going in, even off the 13, it didn't look good, but she hit it well. This leaves her out for a 7-4 lead. Draw it back an inch or two, she should be golden. Okay, Chen moves back ahead by three racks. Looks like Darren is still trailing Lee Bo 8-6 right now. Thank you for the update, Shirley. Chen with two solids on the break. Chen's looking good for an 8-4 lead here. Break and run from Chen, 8-4 lead. Players are going back on break again. Must be a break every 6 racks here in the finals or for the ladies. And Kelly's struggles with the break continue. A little surprised she would take the 13 ball here with what looks like the 10 up there, so close to the 8 on the rail. Well, I guess she can move it off the rail here. Yeah, moved it off the rail, moved it to the side pocket. That's perfect. If they're playing 16 racks, Kelly knows she won't be leading going into the break, but she needs every rack she can get now. Biggest obstacle is going to be this six ball down here on the short rail. I'm not sure she's going to like this next shot. Nice shot there. Looks like she might have left herself wrong side of the one ball. But with this cloth again, she should be fine. Gonna have to hit this ball pretty firm, and firm has not been the recommended way to play a ball down a rail on this table. Ooh, that ball thought about staying up. Kelly back within three at 8-5. And it sounds like it's fireworks time outside again. It's a rare dry break from Chen. First place in the women's division is just over 60,000. Looks like the five goes by the two here. Still got a lot of work down table to do. No, the five must not go by. I think if it did, she'd shoot it now. It sure looks like it goes by. It's going to leave a mark. Even if she makes the two, I don't like getting back on the five. I think she'll just play safe. No, she went for it. safety place seems to be just leave the cue ball near a rail as much distance as possible. Nobody's willing to take a real flyer on a ball here. That looks like it should be no rail. Again. Kelly's looking good here to get back to 8-6. Left a little more angle than she wanted, but she's fine. Eight, six, Kelly. Kelly will be breaking. See if she can figure out this break. And to answer the question, no, Kelly has still not figured out the break. May not hurt her too much here, though. Chen might try to back cut that two to the corner, but that's a scary shot to get a run started with. No, from that angle, she doesn't even have that. But I didn't think she had the angle on that 7, but she sure did. I think she would have liked to have moved that 5 out. Although the way the shot was going, the 5 wasn't going to go anywhere positive. She's got the 1 here. She's got the 6 if she really wants to try it. She looks like she's trying to take this 2 on, which, yeah, that I don't see that being the ideal shot. She's still going to have to get this 5 out. I have no idea what she's looking at here. Looks like she's drawing over to break the 5 out. Nope. Let's see where she left it. Well, that's not going to hurt her. I can't tell. It sure doesn't look like she was planning to make that ball. But if she were playing it safe, I'm surprised she hit it that hard. She should have just left it taken over the pocket. Looks like a good safety from Kelly. Chen could back cut this 4, but that seems like a low probability shot. I think she's playing safe instead here. And I'd be wrong again. Boy, she's opening up her stroke now. Back to the give up ball in hand and put a ball on the rail approach. Play the 11 and move the ball off the rail. She caught enough of the edge of that pocket to still leave it for her in the side. And I think she still has the 12. Although she could go 14, 15, 13. She wants to get that 9 up off there now, then just leave herself the center of the table for everything else. I thought 14, 15, 13, 9, 10, 8. Then again, I'm sitting up here and she's down there playing. I don't know what happened there. She didn't try to do too much with the cue ball. Good safety. I don't see Kelly taking on this 13. Although I'm not sure where her safety is. Maybe come up and try to leave her on the two. Oh, she went for it. She's going to get a big reward for it, too. That was a nice shot. She doesn't catch the edge of that side pocket. She's in trouble. She knows it. So get her back within one. If they're really playing to 16, we could be at an 8-8 tie here at the break. She had a couple balls that threatened the pocket. For Kelly to come back and tie this at 8-8 at the break, that would be a big momentum swing for her. Of course, after you win four games in a row, the last thing you want to do is take a break and let your opponent collect themselves for a couple hours. Looks like she's just going to settle here on this two ball. Try to make the two and follow it up for the one. Rack doesn't get much easier after that. Had to hit that ball absolutely perfect, and that was far from it. Chen's got everything out in the open now. Looks like she's going to shoot this 12 to get things started.
Mm-hmm.
looks pretty straightforward here for Chen to take another 2-rack lead. She doesn't want to be straight on this ball. She hit that ball good, and this is not a gimme on the 8. Wow, very nice shot. Okay, let's see if this is when we take our break for between sessions. Maybe not. Surely, I think you're losing your patience. I'm surprised they're not taking a break here. Of course, if they're playing 17 racks, there wouldn't really be a need to take a break with one rack to go. Again, Kelly will... see if she can figure out this break. She's broke the balls hard. Just nothing's going in. Looked like she tried to duplicate Chen's break there. She made a ball. She made the 8 ball. And that earns her the right to shoot again. Wait, I'm... That should be all Chen needs to get out here and retake a 2-rack lead. Everything's near a pocket. Yeah, she's got to make sure she doesn't get funny on the one when she makes the combination. Like she was worried about where she was going to leave that one after she shot the combination. Oh. She's still got the pocket covered, though. I don't think that safety's gonna get things done. I think Chen's gonna get out here. Yep, she's going to navigate this rack, retake a 3-rack lead. Race to 17, come back if you take a break at 10-7. That's not too bad. And I don't see him getting up to take a break. JP's going downstairs to take some pictures. He's going to let us know exactly how many racks they're playing here. Again, a ball right off the break for Chen. As much as Chen has made balls on just about every break, and Kelly has not, it hasn't been the break that has given us this scoreline. Nice shot, considering she had maybe three quarters of a pocket. No, I know how many racks. I know what the race is. I don't know what the break is that they're going to take after the first session. Thank you, Shirley. They're playing the finals of the ladies and the finals of the men with two sessions. Nice break and run for 11-7. The the word from JP is that they're playing 18 games in this session, so this will be the break right here. That takes us to the first break, the only break. Players will come back, I believe, at 4 o'clock and finish this out. And I don't believe we have another match on this table until 1 o'clock.